So, hello everybody. Thanks to the STEAM organization for this event. And I'm going to present my research carried out during my PhD and postdoc experience and concerning the development of innovative natural materials for water remediation purposes. Today, water pollution is one of the most important problems that needs to be solved. Water covers 70% of the world's surface, but only 3% is able for human activities. World Health Organization estimated that around 1 billion people lack drinking water access and 1 million die each year due to disease coming from unsafe drinking water and consumption. The most widespread pollutants in an environment are hydrophobic organic compounds marked by high PM. So, as said before, my studies concern the development of natural materials for water remediation purposes from similar kinds of pollutants by means of modified cellulose fiber to absorb the pollutants from water. The starting material is cellulose extracted from Spanish broom. It's an endemic vegetable that grows in all Mediterranean areas. Our attention has been focused to this vegetable that has a high cellulose content for three main reasons: high chemical and mechanical stability, high specific surface area, and low-cost extraction and functionalization methods. On the other hand, pollutants chosen to evaluate the remediation capacity of cellulose are total petroleum hydrocarbons, bisphenol A for the endocrine disrupting chemicals family, Escherichia coli for pathogenic bacteria, and mercury chloride for heavy metals. Each of these mentioned pollutants have individual physicochemical properties, and for this reason, cellulose modification is necessary in order to remove or degrade them from water. In the case of hydrocarbons, the hydrophobization of cellulose was performed by different agents. In the case of BPA, the hydrophobic-hydrophilic interaction of functionalizing agents were evaluated. For mercury, chelating properties of modified cellulose has been investigated, and a coating of photocatalytic surface has been performed for photochemical degradation of Escherichia coli in water. And this study dealt with the removal of total petroleum hydrocarbons by cellulose fibers modified by 4,4-fifths MDI as a functionalizing agent to remove total petroleum hydrocarbons from water. In this functionalization process, the MDI is used to hydrophobize cellulose fiber by means of the reaction between OH group emerging from fiber surface and isocyanate group of MDI. The reaction allows the formation of a urethane bond. The reaction is conducted in a homemade sieve reactor. The fiber has been introduced in the vessel, and the two nebulizers spread microdroplets of React on the fiber surface. And a very stable urethane linkage is established on the fiber surface. Characterization results confirm the success of the functionalization process. In fact, in the FTR spectra, appears the signal of urethane isocyanate group. XPS analysis confirmed the presence of nitrogen and the presence of the increasing of carbon signal up to 94%. Same analysis confirm also in this case the different morphological surface of the functionalized fiber with respect to the raw fibers, the cellulose raw fibers that become more rugged, and the water contact angle increase starting from 75 degrees increase up to 148 degrees. And batch absorption experiments were performed in order to evaluate the absorption capacity of the fiber with respect to the total petroleum hydrocarbons. A certain amount of fibers were introduced in the several batch system, polluted with different concentration of TPH, ranging from 300 up to 1,200 milligrams liters of TPH. And from figure A, we can see that the TPH concentration starts to decrease after 10-50 minutes. But in the case of functionalized fibers, after 2 hours, the removal efficiency reached around 96% with respect to that of raw fibers, that is that reach the removal efficiency of 50%. Experimental data collected with different TPH concentration and different mass of fiber has been modeled by different kinetic models. The best one is the pseudo-second order model, indicating that the kinetic constant of the functionalized fibers is around five times bigger with respect to that the raw one. On the other hand, the thermodynamic aspect of the absorption process were investigated by absorption isotherm at 20 degrees. And the isotherm is the plot of the equilibrium absorption capacity and the equilibrium concentration of the pollutant. And in this case, the collected data were well fitted by the Langwein model, and the maximum absorption capacity reached the value of 200 milligrams per gram. In the second functionalization process, an innovative technique called low-pressure plasma technique is used to hydrophobize cellulose fiber with fluorine group to remove TPH from water. Fibers, as in this case, is placed in the plasma apparatus, and a flow of CF4 is introduced with different RF power. And we can see from the characterization results that the VCA, the water contact angle measurement, increased from 75 degrees until to 160 degrees. And another important signal that we have observed is that the same analysis confirmed the different morphological behavior of the morphological surface of the fibers. And with RF power of 70 watt, the functionalization process damage the fibers, and the water contact angle decrease around 150 degrees. Also in this case, batch experiments were performed to evaluate the absorption capacity with respect to TPH. In this case, the removal efficiency reached the value of 100% after only 60 minutes of treatment. Kinetic data, also in this case, was modeled by different kinetic models, pseudo-first order, Elovich, pseudo-second order. The best results were obtained with the pseudo-second order, and the thermodynamic aspect were investigated also with the isotherm, and the Langwein model were fitted the observed data, and the Qmax in this case is 273 milligrams per grams of fibers. We performed other experiment with the same fibers, employed to remove the TPH from water. And now we change the pollutant, but we used the same fiber functionalized in the first case to remove BPA from water. For bisphenol A, this is the most emerging ADC in the environment, and is a fundamental organic chemical used as monomer in the production of polycarbonate plastics. The experiment were well conducted at different pH, from 4 until to 9, and we can see that the pH of the solution determines the ionization state of both the absorbent functionalized fiber and the absorbed pollutants BPA. In this case, we can see that the concentration of the BPA starts to decrease after 5 minutes of treatment, but the best results were obtained at pH around 5. Also, in this case, the experimental data were modeled by different kinetic models. The best one is the pseudo-second order, and in the isotherm, were fitted by the Langwein model with a Qmax, a maximum absorption capacity of 5 milligrams per gram of fiber, with a hair score of close to one. Further experiments were conducted in different water matrices, ultra-pure water, bottled water, synthetic wastewater. As the figure shows, the absorption capacity decreases with the increasing of the compounds in water, but removal efficiency remained high, and the selectivity of the process is confirmed by cold and TOC measurement. Other experiments were performed in order to evaluate the reuse of fiber, and we can see that the usability after alkaline washing remained very satisfactory. We change pollutant, and process of functionalizing, but no material. In fact, fabric obtained from cellulose spinning were coated with TiO2 layer by low plasma technique that used a target of titanium, which is shot by a flow of argon and oxygen. We can see the figure in this case. And this technique permitted the generation of the nanoparticles of TiO2 that were deposited on the to the fabric surface. This fabric were used as antibacterial substrate for E. coli degradation by UV lead. XPS analysis confirmed the presence of titanium on the fabric surface that increased with increasing of oxygen content in the plasma feed gas. Bacterial inactivation experiments were performed of different initial concentration of E. coli, ranging from 10 to 3 until from 10 to 8, with the best fabric obtained in the functionalization process. And after 45 minutes of treatment, E. coli in water was inactivated. The kinetic was evaluated for different E. coli concentration and exhibit a pseudo first order kinetic. In fact, in all cases, K is the kinetic constant is almost the same, which does not depend with the initial concentration of E. coli. All the experiments were conducted in different water matrix, in distilled water, bottled water, subwater, and water polluted with different concentration of humic acid. As expected, the inactivation depends on the chemical compounds in water, but it remains high, but slower. In fact, the humic acid, in the worst case, in the humic acid, have the ability to cover the E. coli surface and protect him from UV. At the end, the last studies, at the end we developed a new method for cellulose hydrolysis, and this green cellulose conversion generates bio oil and cellulose citrate, uses molten citric acid in an open system. The cellulose citrate was used to remove mercury from water. Experiments in this case were conducted in different batch system with different initial concentration of mercury chloride ranging from 1 ppm until to 100 ppm. Preliminary results are very important with a removal efficiency close to 95%. This removal efficiency decreases with the increasing of other compounds in water. So other water matrices employed in this study is ultra-pure water, bottled water, or synthetic wastewater. Selectivity tests at hand for several metals were performed. In this case, the removal efficiency in the case of lead is around 94%, with an initial concentration of about 1 ppm. So while for mercury and copper is around 18%, and 87% for mercury, starting from an initial concentration of 0.44 and 0.64 ppm respectively. And in conclusion, we can say that all purification systems are stable after several reuse cycles and can be easily regenerated by a simple and fast washing procedure. For total petroleum hydrocarbons, we reach the removal of 90% after 10 minutes of treatment. In the second case, with the low pressure plasma functionalized cellulose fibers, the efficiency is higher, around 100%. For bisphenol A, around 70%, and at pH 5. For Escherichia coli, after 45-60 minutes treatment, the inactivation is total. And then for the mercury, the cellulose citrate show a good absorption capacity and around 94% with an initial concentration of 1 ppm and 88% for an initial concentration of 100 milligrams liters of mercury chloride in water. And thank you for your kind invitation, and I would like to thanks all my research group and the whole international collaboration in my university. Thank you so much.